Today, I'm going to show you the basic method to teaching a dog the behavior sit and the introduction to down. An A Plus Digital production featuring John Corbett and his boerboel.
That is wonderful.
Let's remember, having fun is what it's all about. Zoo is in his third week of training with Mr. Corbett.
Zoo!
The most important thing in dog training is praise. I often recommend a leash to gain control of the animal when first starting. Also remember, the dog isn't pleasing you, but pleasing himself. So remember to have a treat every time the dog displays the desired behavior, followed by, "That's a good girl or boy." I'm sure after that, your dog will continue to please himself as well as you. A great way to get your dog's attention is his favorite toy. However, every dog is willing to work for food. You can use your dog's food before feeding, a store brand treat, which are sometimes low in fat, cheese, bologna, or hot dogs. The best thing to do is to cut small, fine pieces. You do not want to give away the entire treat to maintain the dog's attention. This is the reasoning behind such small pieces. Here you see we are cutting small pieces to give you an idea of the size.
Okay.
And a small piece of cookie for me. Now we're ready for dog training. Let's go.
If you're gonna do dog training for basic training, it's to maintain control of your dog. You can get a leash from any of your pet stores. Just go down to the local store and get a leash.
Hey, you wanna work? You wanna work? You wanna play a game? You wanna play a game?
The first thing I do is I get a piece of food. And I let the dog see the piece of food. And I'll tease him with it.
Good boy. Good boy.
Praise is the most important thing in dog training. With praise, and the leash is a communication to your dog. Once you give your dog praise, he knows that he's done the right thing. So the first thing we'll do is say, "Good boy," once he sits. Because if you say, "Good boy," that's gonna mean that he's done something right. So we'll do it again. You can either use a piece of bologna or his favorite dog food. If you're worried about the dog getting fat, or you can use his treats, whichever one he likes. Here again. Good. I see. And you notice I placed the treat behind his head, so it pushes in the motion of sit. Remember to reward your dog every time he exhibits the desired behavior with a good boy and a treat. Because timing is everything. I like to use the word marker. Marker is just the same as what you see the local dog trainers at your pet store using clickers. Good boy is just the same thing as the clicker. It's the marker that the dog has just done the desired behavior. That tells the dog that he's doing exactly what you asked of him. So remember to say good boy every time.
course, this is a advanced trained dog. So I'll show you what the sit looks like, and then I'll show you the down. Because before you can teach a dog down, you must teach him to sit. So I'll demonstrate a down with the sit.
Awesome.
The motion of the hand. Good boy. Good boy. Doing good.
That's not the normal.
So, sit.
Pull your hand up.
Sit. Sit.
The first one.
Refrain from using a command twice. Say it only once, followed by a no. If the dog doesn't exhibit the desired behavior.
Good boy.
You go to the sit.
Sit. Sit. Sit. Down. 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 All the way down. Good boy. Good boy.
Bring him up.
Make him focus.
No.
Tell him sit.
No. Sit. Sit.
Tell him push down.
Down. Down, 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 down.
Don't give it to him.
Down.
Tell him no.
No.
Sit.
Sit.
Now down.
Down. Down. Down. Down. Down.
Now, good boy. Throw the ball. Good boy. Throw it. Throw it. Now throw it. Good boy. You see what I'm saying? You use his toys as the same thing as treats.
Remember, only reward the dog when the dog has all the way sitting, or is all the way down. Never halfway. Halfway is never right.
Okay.
Remember, timing and praise is everything to successful dog training. And your dog will be doing exactly what you asked of him in no time at all. It's now time for Animal Awareness.
Can we ask you some questions
yes,
today?
Yes, you can.
All right. One of the questions is, which of these three items
to it. You gotta get closer to it.
Would poison your animal? Would it be taffy, chocolate, or gum?
Well, basically, they say chocolate, but then again, they have chocolate now made for animals. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say that it would totally poison. It would mess up their digestive system.
If your dog is home alone, he should be available to what? A, your couch, B, water, or C, his favorite toy?
Everything, because I spoil animals. Everything. Basically, but the dog that I had, he had to run at the house. And if you train a dog right, they will not get on your furniture though, but water, food, and the favorite toy, a safe toy.
Okay, and that was correct. If your dog was home alone, what wouldn't you do, or would you consider inhumane? One, leaving it more than 6 hours. Two, leaving it roaming the streets. Or C, eating your favorite pack of hot dogs.
I think leaving it home more than 6 hours.
No, roaming the street.
Oh.
Is it inhumane to one, have your dog roaming the street, two, in the house alone for 6 hours, or three, eating a bag of your favorite hot dog?
Eating a bag of my favorite hot dogs.
No, one of the three.
To me, oh, it's the dog roaming the streets.
Yes, it is roaming the streets.
A dog trainer now. I know how to train it.
Woo! He gonna be all right, boy. He gonna be all right.
If you're interested in working puppies, just give us a call at 904-764-4043.
Ba-do-do-do.